I am Hall of Fame coach Van Chastler. This is my van. This is Coaches in a Van with Coach Van. Coach Lardner's father was a legend at Picayune High School, wrote a book on basketball. Coaches, it hard living up to your dad's reputation?
Well, you know, I've never looked at it like that, Coach. I feel real blessed, though, to grow up as the son of a basketball coach and feel blessed to be at my age being able to coach basketball. And it really is. I feel truly blessed.
Okay. You were a high school coach in South Mississippi, a junior college coach. Now you're coaching at Southeastern Louisiana. Tell us kind of what are the differences in the three different levels?
Well, you know, I certainly hadn't taken the road most traveled to Division I. And I love my time in high school. I was at St. Stanislaus High School for 20 years on the Mississippi Gulf Coast. Fortunate to go to Jones Junior College from there. And so I've gotten a little taste of each level. The biggest part, Coach, I'll be honest with you, and you can probably relate better than anybody, you spend less time coaching at Division I than you did at junior college and high school. And I thought it would be different because you don't have some of the other the class, you know, responsibilities, teaching classes and so forth. But we have so many other responsibilities, you don't get as much time coaching basketball.
That's when you're on the Division I level, you spend an extra amount of time of recruiting with,
yes,
and so many other things. I think the demand on your time is much greater. Would you agree with that?
I totally agree. That absolutely. There's an incredible amount of time, 7 days a week, really 365 days a year now.
Yes, I thought this when one of the reasons I wanted to retire out of college coaching, it just demanded so much of my time when I was away from the office recruiting, and social media has changed recruiting.
Absolutely no question about that. A coach that doesn't understand social media, and I try to stay on top of those things as much as possible, is probably behind.
Yes. What's your favorite music? When you're not coaching, you're riding in the car going home, what do you like to listen to?
Coach, you and I are both old Mississippi boys. I like that old outlaw country music. My players laugh at me all the time.
Oh, yeah.
You know, I like Waylon Jennings and Nelson and all that.
I tell them I have four grandboys. I said, boys, y'all going to appreciate music till you've listened to classic country.
Absolutely.
I got this same van right here, and I got three of my stations on country music.
Well, I actually, to be honest with you, I like a little bit of all. I like 80s music, growing up in that area, 70s and 80s. I like the old rhythm and blues. I like the soul music, you know, and really some of the original rap music from back before they had to start using a lot of the different language they use now.
Well, Coach, I'm going to challenge you right here on television. You go to Katy this spring, you win it, and you qualify for the NCAAs. Your players and I want you to show us your best dance move. Well, can you do that for us? What is that going?
I don't know if I could do that. They wouldn't understand two-stepping anyway, would they, Coach?
Hey, man, if y'all win the championship this year and qualify, I'm going to personally be there and make him show us something in the center court. Don't worry about that.
I promise you this. I will do something. I promise you this. I would be that excited.
Well, thanks, Coach.
Thank you, Coach.
Always great seeing you.
Great honor to talk to you.
Thank you.